In this video, we will be discussing the tool to calculate the sample size when we're dealing with mean in Google Sheets. So let's begin. So we are interested in finding the sample size when we're dealing with a mean. And so that is dealing with this portion right up here. And notice that we're on the tab that says sample size, and it is the far right tab on this confidence interval and sample size tool. So in our problem that we're dealing with, we have the SAT scores are distributed with a mean of 1400 and a standard deviation of 320. You're interested in estimating the average SAT score of first year students at your college. If you would like to limit the margin of error of your 95% confidence interval to 22 points, how many students should you sample? So you want to have a certain margin of error. That's what we're interested in having. So we have dealt with calculating the confidence interval. And in this case, we want to have a certain margin of error, which is that portion that we're adding and subtracting to the mean to find the confidence interval. We want to shrink the margin of error to be within 22 points. And what we notice is if we increase the sample size, that decreases the margin of error. So we want to figure out how large of a sample size do we need to have this limited margin of error. So we will use this tool to find that out. We need the population standard deviation, margin of error, and the confidence level. So we have a mean of 1400 and a standard deviation of 320. So notice that this calculation does not at all involve the mean. So mean of 1400, that's just extra information that we do not need to use in this problem. But we do need the standard deviation of 320. So now we also need the margin of error, and that's the within a certain portion. So we would like to limit the margin of error of your 95% confidence interval to 22 points. So we want to be within 22 points. So the margin of error in this case is 22. And now we need the confidence level. So if we want a 95% confidence interval, the confidence level is that 95%. And we want to put this in decimal form, a 0.95. And notice that, I'll just point this out, that this function involves round up. It's already built in, but it says round up. This tells you that whatever, if you were to do this by hand, if we were to calculate this by hand, we would want to take our solution and round it up to the nearest whole number. Now, not the nearest whole number, but round up to the nearest whole number. So if you had, for example, let's just get out of here. If you had 812.1, you would not round down to 812. You would round up to the nearest whole number, which is 813. So always round up. And the reason for this is because we want to be within a certain margin of error. And if we were to round down, that would increase the margin of error. As I mentioned, it's an inverse relationship. So if we were to increase the sample size, that decreases the margin of error. And if we want to be within 22 points, then it's 22 or less. So sample size has to increase. So if we round down, that will not happen. You must round up. That is always the rule when you're dealing with the sample size tool. All right, so that is how you use this tool to find the necessary sample size to have a certain margin of error in a problem.